Hey and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have 5 tool updates, 1 cross tool update, and 3 general updates to share today. Let's start with our first tool update, which is actually a completely new tool, competitive analysis. This is where you find a new and improved content gap tool. Content gap shows you keywords your competitors are ranking for that yours isn't, which can reveal gaps in your content coverage and strategy. For example, let's say we want to find blog ideas that our competitors are covering that we have yet to write about. I'll enter a blog URL along with a few competitors, then hit the compare button. And right away, in the table below, we can see the keywords that at least one of our competitors ranks for in the top 10, where our blog doesn't rank in the top 100. Now, this was also doable in the old content gap tool, but we've added some new features and filters to make the new content gap much more flexible and actionable. There are 3 things I'll highlight today. Firstly, we've added a new heat map. It's the first thing you see in the new content gap, and it shows us the number of keywords our blog has in common with our competitors. A darker color means a higher number of shared keywords. Secondly, in the old content gap, there was no way to set position filters, but now you can. So, let's say that we want to zoom in on blog topics that could use some TLC. We can set the filters to show keywords where our blog ranks in positions 11 to 20, and where at least one of our competitors ranks in the top 10. Or, let's say we want to improve the relevancy of keywords. We can set the filters to show keywords where the target is not ranking, plus two or more specific competitors are ranking in the top 10. Finally, in the old content gap, you couldn't filter out certain sub-features, but now you can. Just use this main positions only toggle to filter out positions in SERP features like image packs and top stories. We're still working on this report and adding more features, so stay tuned for updates. Competitive analysis is available for all new standard plans and above. We haven't removed the old content gap report for now, so legacy light plans can still use it. Moving on to Site Explorer. We have 2 new updates in Overview 2.0. Firstly, we've added the domain rating history chart in both the general and backlink profile views. In the performance chart, toggle the domain rating metric on to track your target's DR over time. Secondly, we've added a new widget to Overview 2.0 that shows the number of unique pages crawled over the last 6 months and how it's changed over the last 30 days, along with a breakdown by HTTP status code below the chart. Moving on to Keywords Explorer. First up, we've updated our search volume estimates in Keywords Explorer. Before, misspellings of groups of keywords with the same search volumes were causing spikes in organic traffic. So we started working to detect more keyword clusters and adjusted the search volume of keywords belonging to the same cluster. With this update, you should now notice a spike in keywords, but a smaller spike in organic traffic. Next, we've added sparklines that show changes in search volume over the past 12 months to all keyword ideas reports in Keywords Explorer. This gives you a great overview of search volume trends at a glance. Moving on to one cross tool update. We've added an inspect button in the URL context menu. From any Ahrefs report, just click on the caret next to a URL and then hit inspect to look at its source code, page text, and compare changes between dates. We've also started hiding HTML snapshots for pages with the no archive tag. Moving on to Rank Tracker. We've updated the SERP overview table in Rank Tracker to match the data source we're using in Site Explorer and Keywords Explorer. Metrics should now be more accurate and also better aligned with the other tools. We've also unified the list of metrics by removing hsrank and adding the words column. And we also now show non-200 HTTP codes for all search results. Moving on to Content Explorer. We've added all primary filters to the landing page of Content Explorer. This means that you can now apply all the filters you'd like in your initial search. Moving on to our general updates. First up, a small improvement to user management. From account settings, you can now select multiple users and edit their credit usage limits in bulk. Next up, we've released a bunch of new free tools, AI-powered writing generators, which will get your writing off to a fantastic start. Each tool specializes in a single task, from paraphrasing any chunk of text to generating meta descriptions for your pages. They all use ChatGPT's API. I'll leave a link to the tools in the description below. And finally, an update for our API V3 for enterprise plans. We've released endpoints for the remaining keyword ideas reports, related terms, and search suggestions. I'll leave links to the docs below. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our canon. See you in the next update and have a great day.